Hello all, welcome back to netstrikers.com. In this tutorial, that is tutorial number 48, we are going to learn about passing message from server to the client. Now, in order to create a program to demonstrate the socket programming for passing the message from server to client, we need to create two classes. The first one is the client.java, as you can see here, while the other we need to create server.java. Now the purpose of the client is to send request, where the server task is to receive the request. But in this example, we are transmitting from the server to client. So let us take an example. So I just need to minimize it first and open this editor. Okay. Now I have imported a class, two packages. First one is IO package, while the other one is the net package. I've created a class called client. Within the main method, I have created a try catch block to handle the unknown host exception as well as the IO exception. Now, as we discussed earlier, we need to create a socket object, which could be S, and the socket constructor would take the IP address and the port number, which is in the int format. Now this will going to print that connected successfully. Now the buffered reader object reads the character, and we created the buffered reader object BR followed by the new buffered reader within the input stream reader to get all the input stream. Now we printed out the response from the server from the system.out.println, and it will print from the buffered reader object readline method. Now it's always a good practice to close the connection once you open it. Now let's open the server.java class. Now the server.java is quite different from the client side, as we are going to create the server socket instead of just socket. Now I just name my object as SS. Since the server socket constructor take only one parameter, which is the port number through which it want to connect. Now we responded to the user that waiting for the request. Now let us create the socket object. I name it as S, and it will accept the server socket. Now the accept method reside in the socket. It accept all the connections. Now I printed out this request accepted, followed by the print stream. Now the task of the print stream is to print all the data from the object via a stream medium. Now the buffered reader object will help in order to input the stream of the buffer. Now this system.out.println will input the data into the server, while the print stream, which is this object, will print the buffered reader data. Now since in our previous client class we closed that connection, so here we also will close the connection s.close ss.close, and we handle all the exception by the catch block itself. Now let us run our program to demonstrate how this thing works. So I just need to open this terminal. Single terminal here, and I need to open another terminal. Okay. Now let us close this stuff. Now let us run our first code, first compile it. So we are going to compile client.java. So as you can see, our compilation successful. Now let's compile our server class, server.java. Now this also compiled successfully. Now we are going to run the server. So to run the server, we need to type java followed by the server. Now as you can see, server is waiting for the request from the client. So we are going to send the request from our client program. So just type java followed by the client and press enter. As soon as you press enter, the request is accepted, followed by a prompt message which says input the data at the server. Whereas on the client side, we get the response from the server. That means they both are connected with each other. Now whatever data which I am going to type here within the server panel will get reflected and responded into the client side. So I am going to type hello Aditya with a smiley, and I'm going to send to the client. As you can see, client side, hello Aditya with a smiley. Now that's how a socket program passing message from the server client work. And if you have any suggestions or doubt, please do let me ask in the YouTube comment section. Thanks for watching.